Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Now in this video I'm going to discuss a few tips related to the topic electrostatics. Now you can call them as tips or you can call them as results, but they will be useful for your forthcoming entrance examination. Now suppose you have two charges. Okay, so this is a positive charge plus Q, this is another positive charge plus Q. Both the charges are identical. Okay, let me join them through a line. And suppose the two charges are separated by distance twice A, and this is the midpoint. Okay, and this is the perpendicular bisector, and this is some point P. Okay, now if these are positive charges, both are same magnitude charges, then the electric field at this point along the perpendicular bisector, it will be directed along this line, along the bisector, away from the charges. Okay, provided these charges are positive. Okay, now instead of these two positive charges, if you have negative charges, the resultant field at this point will be directed along this direction towards the charges. Okay, and the value of this electric field, it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught twice Q divided by A square plus y square raised to the power 3 by 2, where y is this distance. Okay, and this quantity multiplied by y. Okay, so this is the value of the resultant field. Okay, now in case, as I told you, these charges are replaced by negative charges, then the value of the field will be same, magnitude will be same, but it will be directed in this direction. Okay, now in case y is very much greater than a, this is very much greater than a, so a square plus y square will be replaced by y square, so this quantity will be E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2q by y square. Okay, that is, if this point P is very far away, then these two charges will behave like as if they are placed at the same point 2q and at distance y. So this is the expression for the resultant field. Okay, now another important result, what will be the maximum value of electric field? Okay, now electric field will be maximum when dE by dy, it is equal to 0. Okay, now if you differentiate this and equate it to 0, then you will get y is equal to plus minus a by root 2. So at this location, electric field will be maximum. Now y is equal to plus minus a by root 2 means a by root 2 distance along this direction and a by root 2 distance along this direction, the electric field will be maximum. And what will be the, now if you substitute the value of this y over here, you'll get the maximum value of electric field, and that maximum value is E max is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 4q divided by 3 root 3 a square. Okay, this is the value of the maximum electric field. Now in case y is very much smaller than a, okay, now in that case the electric field, that is this P point is very close to this line, in that case this electric field expression is qy divided by 2 pi epsilon naught aq. Okay, when y is very much smaller than a, this a square plus y square will be replaced by a square, and you will get this result. Okay, now if we place a charge minus q, okay, at that location, at that distance y, so in that case the force on the negative charge, suppose the charge, negative charge minus q is placed over here, so this negative charge will experience a force in this direction. Okay, so it will move in this direction. The moment it crosses this point, it will start again experiencing force in the opposite direction. So this negative charge will start oscillating like this. Okay, and that period of oscillation will be given by T is equal to twice pi square root of twice pi epsilon naught M A Q divided by QQ. Okay, how do you get this? This is electric field. From the electric field, you get the expression for force on the charge, that is F is equal to Q into E. Okay, and that is equal to E is this electric field, Q is the charge which is placed. I'm considering the magnitude only. Now this force is equal to M omega square Y, where M is the mass of the charge, and from this you get the value of omega. From the omega you can get the value of time period. So this is the expression for period of oscillation of this negative charge. Now similarly, if you have a ring of charge, positively charged ring, okay, it is uniformly charged, okay, and suppose Q is the charge and radius is A, this is the center, this is the axis, this is some point P. Okay, now again, if this ring is positively charged, electric field will be along this axis away from the ring, and the resultant electric field E will be equal to Q X, X is resistance, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught X square plus A square raised to the power 3 by 2. This is the value of electric field. Now as you can see, at center of the ring X is equal to 0, so E is also equal to 0. Okay, now if X is very much greater than A, that is when you are far away from the ring, then X square plus A square will be X square, that is about 3 by 2. So this is X cube, this X cancels out, so E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X square. That is when you are far away from the ring, this ring will behave like a point charge. Okay, and how about the maximum value of electric field? Again, you have to find d by dx equated to 0 for E is equal to E max. Okay, now again, this value comes to be x equal to plus minus A by root 2. So at distance A by root 2 in this direction and A by root 2 in this direction, electric field is maximum. Okay, and what is the maximum value of the electric field? E max is equal to, you substitute this value of x over here, you get the maximum value of electric field as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught twice Q divided by 3 root 3 A square. Now if you are very close to the ring, when X is very much smaller than A, in that case electric field, so this X square plus A square becomes A square, so E is equal to QX divided by 4 pi epsilon naught A cube. Okay, so now if lambda is the, so this is the expression for electric field, but if lambda is the linear charge density, then in terms of lambda, this lambda is a linear charge density, means Q by charge per unit length, so Q by twice pi A, so this Q by twice pi A can be replaced by lambda, so in that case E will be lambda X by 2 epsilon naught A square. This is in terms of linear charge density. Okay, now again, if we place a negative charge close to the ring for small value of X, the force on the negative charge will be, suppose the charge is minus Q, so in that case minus lambda Q divided by 2 epsilon naught A square. Now again, if the charge is placed, negative charge is placed over here, it will experience a force in this direction towards the ring. So it will move like this, it will move to the other side, and then again it will start experiencing attractive force. So this negative charge will start oscillating. Okay, and this oscillation period will be given by T is equal to twice pi A square root of twice epsilon naught M divided by lambda Q. How do you get this? This again, you write this expression for electric field. From the expression for electric field, you get the value of force. Now that force is equal, if you get the value of force, then force is equal to M omega square X. Okay, so from that you get the value of omega, from omega you get the value of T. Okay, so these are some of the results, and I hope this video will be beneficial for your forthcoming examination. Best wishes.